Dear students, in this session we are going to solve the problems on preparation of a purchases book. This question from the examination point view is asking for 6 marks. It's very easy to prepare the purchases book or purchase journal. Now I read out the problem first and next I go to the solution. From the following particulars, prepare purchases book. 2020 January 1st, bought goods from Dev for cash ₹12,000. On 6th, purchased goods from Kavita at a discount of 5%, ₹20,000. On 9th, goods purchased on credit from Shiva for ₹8,000. On 16th, Jyoti supplied goods to us ₹10,000. And 20, printer purchased for cash ₹12,000. These are the transactions given you in the problem. From these transactions, you have to prepare the purchases book or purchases journal. While preparing the solution, or while preparing the answer for this question, first read out the transaction clearly, understand properly, then enter the transactions in the purchases book rightly. This is the thing you have to follow while preparing the purchases book. From these transactions, now I would like to prepare the purchases book. On 1st of January, purchased goods from Dev for cash ₹12,000. As we'll go back, the purchase book means, purchase book is a book which is going to record, or in which we are going to record only the credit transactions, not cash transactions. That's why on 1st, the goods which have been purchased from Dev on cash is not going to be recorded, or this transaction will not be appeared in the purchases book. Next, on January 6th, purchased goods from Kavita for ₹20,000 at a discount of 5%. First, on date column, enter the date January 6, 2020. Write the name of the supplier, Kavita. Enter the name, enter the amount, ₹20,000. At a discount of 5%, this discount should be deducted from the total value of ₹20,000. That is, 5% on 20,000 comes to ₹1,000. The net amount entered in the main column, ₹19,000. Then on 9th of January, goods purchased on credit from Shiva amounted to ₹8,000. Enter the date 9. Write the name of the supplier, Shiva. Enter the amount, or record the amount, ₹9,000. Then on 16th of January, Jyoti supplied goods to us. Here means the supplier supplied the goods to us, then it is a purchase transaction based on credit, hence it is to be recorded in purchases book. Write the date 16. Write the name of the supplier, Jyoti, amount ₹10,000. Next, on 20th January, printer purchased for cash ₹20,000. It is an asset which has been purchased on January 20th based on cash. That's why this transaction should not be entered in the purchaser's book. Then after entering all the credit transactions, that is goods purchased from Kavita at rupees 20,000 by allowing 5% discount, and goods purchased from Shiva on credit amounted to rupees 9,000, and Jyoti supplied goods to us, that is rupees 10,000. After entering these credit transactions in purchaser's book, now you will total up the amount column. The total comes to rupees 38,000. Then after the preparation of the purchaser's book, regarding cash transactions, don't forget, you have to compulsorily give the note. Purchased goods from Dev for cash will not appear in purchaser's book. As well, on 20th, purchased printer for cash, it will not appear in the purchaser's book. In this way, you have to prepare purchase book neatly and present it. This question will be asked for 6 marks. This is the solution which has been solved on the board. You have to go through this. I hope you, all of you, understand properly. Now I will take up the second problem, which has already been written on the board. Prepare purchase journal from the following transactions. Date April 1st 2020, purchase goods from Gagan rupees 7500. On April 5, Vinay supplied goods to us rupees 3000. On April 10th, bought goods from Naveen rupees 5000. April 20th, Ravi supplied goods on credit rupees 12,000 at a 10% discount, and on 25th, building purchased for cash rupees 1,50,000. This is the problem. From these transactions, we have to prepare the purchase journal or purchase book. Draft the layout of the purchase book. Divide it into the 5 columns: date, invoice number, name of the supplier, amount. After drafting the format of the purchase book, write up the title, purchase journal or purchase book. Go through the dates given in the problem. This problem, 2020 April 1st, purchased goods from Gagan rupees 7500. Write up the name of the supplier Gagan. Write the amount rupees 7500. On April 5th, Vinay supplied goods to us. This transaction indirectly inform us the supplier Mr. Vinay supplied the goods to the business enterprise amounted to rupees 3000. The students are going to read out carefully the transaction. Some transactions have been given indirectly in the problem. There is no doubt this transaction is a credit transaction related with the purchase of goods from Mr. Vinay. It is to be recorded in purchaser's book. Write up the date 5, the name of the supplier Vinay, rupees 3000. Next, on 10th of April, bought goods from Naveen. When the students are reading the transaction, when they come across the term bought, they might think of that it is to be entered in sales book. It's absolutely wrong. bought goods from Navin is nothing but purchased goods from Navin. So it is entered in the purchaser's journal right up the date April 10. The supplier name is Navin, amount rupees 5000. Next, on 20th, Ravi supplied goods on credit. The total value of the goods is rupees 12,000 at a discount of 10%. Enter the date April 20. Write up the name of the supplier Ravi. The total value of the goods is 12,000 and deduct the amount of discount, that is 10% on rupees 12,000 comes to rupees 1,200. The net value is to be recorded in the purchaser's book, that is rupees 10,800. Then all the transaction which have been based on the ground of the credit are entered in the purchaser's book properly. Finally, you make the total of the amount column, the total comes to rupees 26,300. In this manner, we have to prepare purchase book. And one more transaction is there in the problem. On 25th, building purchased for cash. The assets purchased are not going to be recorded in the purchaser's book. That's why building purchased, it is a cash transaction, it will not appear in the purchaser's book. This is the solution for problem number 2. In this format, we have to prepare the purchaser's book and write up the answer. It is very easy, students. Within a few minutes, you are securing 6 marks in the examination. In this format, you have to present your answer clearly, then you are not losing any mark. 6 marks are going to be allotted if your answer is like this. That is all. After knowing the preparation of the purchaser's book, next part is that preparation of the sales book or sales journal book. In the earlier class, I have already explained the meaning of the sales book. It's very simple. Sales book is a book in which we are going to record the credit sales of goods. Sales book is a book in which we record the sales transaction of goods on credit basis. Now we are going to solve the 2 problems. When practically problems have been solved, you are getting the answer very easily. I read out the problem first, which has been already given on this board, and then I will move on to the solution. Problem number first: from the following transactions, prepare sales book. Dates of the transaction: 2020, February 2nd, sold goods to Suma on credit rupees 12,500. On 14th February, supplied goods to Swati rupees 9,700. On 19th February, invoice sent to Sonu rupees 5,300. On 20th, Malini bought goods from us at a trade discount 12% of rupees 20,000. On 26th, sold goods to Surya for cash rupees 8,500. These are the transactions given to you in the problem. Now you are going to give the answer for that, or you will be in a position to prepare the solution for this problem. While solving the problem, first draft the format of the sales book. After drafting the layout of the sales book, write the title sales book and write up the columns. First column is date, second column invoice number, third column name of the customer, fourth column ledger folio, and last column is to use it to record the amount of the transaction. After drafting the format of the sales book, go through the transactions which have been already given in the problem. Write up the date of the transaction, 2020 February 2nd, sold goods to Suma on credit. Write the name of the customer Suma, and the amount is rupees 12,500. Amount is rupees 12,500. On 14th, supplied goods to Swati, rupees 9,700. Date February 14th. Name of the customer Swati, rupees 9,700. Next, invoice sent to Sono. Nothing but credit transaction. Goods supplied to Sono amounted to rupees 5,300. When the goods are supplied, the business enterprise is going to prepare a document. The document is called as invoice or sales bill. Here, invoice sent to Sono amounted to rupees 5,300. Date 19, customer name Sono, write the rupees 5,300. On 20th February, Malini bought goods from us at a discount 12%. Write up the date on the sales book, date of February 20, name of the customer Malini, total value of the goods rupees 20,000. She has been given the trade discount at 12%, the discount amount is to be deducted. How to calculate the discount? Take up the total value of the goods, rupees 20,000, multiplied by 12, divided by 100, it comes to rupees 2,400. This discount amount is deducted from the total value, and we have to record the amount in amount column, net value of the goods. The net value of the goods after giving the trade discount is rupees 17,600. All the credit transactions related to sale of goods have been entered in the sales book. Then, after entering the respective amounts of the transactions, now at last we are going to make the total of the amount column. The total comes to rupees 45,100. This problem we are getting 5 transactions, but already we have been entered 4 transactions, and one more transaction not recorded in a sales book because the transaction is based on cash basis. For that transaction, you have to give a note: sold goods to Surya for cash will not appear in this book, because it is a transaction based on cash. This is the solution for the first problem. In this proper way, if you have prepared the sales book, there is no doubt, students, you are getting 6 marks in the examination for this question. I hope all of you understand clearly the preparation of a sales book or sales journal. Second problem on the preparation of the sales journal. 2020 April 2nd, sold 10 boxes of pen at rupees 100 per box to Jaya Stores. Date 8, goods supplied to Kumaran of rupees 16,800. Date 15th, cash sales of rupees 16,500. Date 22nd, sold 12 boxes of oil at a discount of 10%, rupees 18,000 to Vani. April 30th, invoice of rupees 9,800 sent to Arun. These are the transactions given to you in the problem number 2. You have to prepare the solution for that problem. Write up the sales journal in the particular format and record the particulars in a separate columns correctly. Then you are going to record the transaction along with the values given with the given in the transactions. 2020 April 2nd, sold goods to Jaya Stores on credit, 10 boxes of pen at rupees 100. Write up the name of the customer, Jaya Stores. 10 boxes multiplied by rupees 100 per box amounts to rupees 1000. On 8th, goods supplied to Kumaran rupees 16,800. Write the date 8, name of the customer Kumaran, amount rupees 16,800. On 22nd, sold 12 boxes of oil at a discount of 10%, rupees 18,000 to Vani. Date 22nd, customer name is Vani. Total value of the oil boxes is rupees 18,000. Deduct the discount amount at 10%. 10% on 18,000 comes to rupees 1,800. The net value 16,200. Next, on 30th, invoice of rupees 9,800 sent to Arun. Date 30, Arun, amount rupees 9,800. Total of the amount column, it comes to rupees 43,800. In this problem, we are getting one cash transaction on April 15th. This transaction based on cash, that is why it should not appear in the sales journal. For that transaction, you have to give a note. Cash sales of rupees 16,500 will not appear in this sales journal. That's all. In this way, you have to prepare sales journal in the correct way. Then you are going to secure the 6 marks easily in the examination. This is regarding the preparation of a purchase book and a sales book. For purchase book, we have solved 2 problems. As well, for sales journal also, I have already solved 2 problems. I hope all of you understand. Then we will go further session, the preparation of the 12 marks question on the preparation of sales journal, purchases journal, purchase returns book and sales returns book.